Yeah, bro. Everybody's talking about Jalen Hurts' stat line from Sunday night. What was it? What was your stat line from? Well, you were doing stupid shit. I ain't your mommy. I ain't going to tell you what you want to hear. You come to me for straight facts.
I love the guy that's like, I'll say anything, that radio host. Oh, yeah. I don't care. I have no boundaries.
Look, here's the deal. This ain't no agenda-driven radio. This is just how it's going to be, and I'm going to tell you how it is.
Fired the next day for racist comments
on
or some
93.7
The Pulse. That was a sick outro. That should probably be our intro. These guys, 21.
TG21.
TG21. Listen on YouTube, Apple Pods, Spotify, Stitcher. Mm-hmm. Wherever you get your podcast, get your merch at benedictmerch.com. We got some These Guys hoodies over there.
Look at this. Little throwback.
Dude, I was just panic putting on clothes, mm-hmm. and I just saw that like 17 seconds ago.
Yeah.
In my drawer. Still got it.
It's perfect because in Indy right now, it's like a solid 53 degrees, sunny.
I know.
So it's not, you know, you're like, hey, I don't need a coat or a jacket. Give me a nice crew. Let's go. This is a throwback here for those on YouTube. Espresso. I think this is like our first merch that we ever did, honestly. We were like clean, classy, cool, simple. Let's do it. And we stuck to it. But yeah, I wore these guys the other day and it's that comfy as shit.
It's nice.
It's real comfy.
Yeah, dude, I'm wearing shorts. He's wearing shorts. He's doing it. Everybody ever. You wearing shorts? Every time you wear shorts. Shorts? I'm like, shut the fuck up. Oh my God, he's wearing shorts again. I'm like, I just worked out. Like, what? People that work out in pants, too. Get a life.
I work out in pants.
Really?
Yeah.
Get a life, bro. Really? You wear pants, though?
I try to work up as much of a sweat as I can.
I like that thinking. But some people, I don't think they're thinking like that. Mm. It's just a lot of clothing, but I wear a hoodie when I work out, so I get it.
Yeah, and you wear the hood up.
Yeah, I love that.
So.
Just fucking see and never.
Yeah.
Not talking to anyone. And people always think I have my AirPods in, and I don't. So people just like rip ass around me and I'm like, I heard it though.
You ever say anything?
No. I'll look at him and be like,
hey. Hey, you just do one of these. You just go pull the hoodie back a little bit. Yeah. No headphones in.
Except for I just ripped 17 seconds ago anyway. So I'm like, hey, same page. You had to cover up my fart with your fart. Deal.
Dude, I think speaking of that, this is going to be the grossest podcast ever.
Good, bro. That's all anybody wants to hear.
Day after the Super Bowl, got to be the fartiest day of all time.
Dude, it's so hard to get going after the Super Bowl. The first
work.
7 hours of the day, I'm like, oh my God.
Everything I was eating last night, all I could think about was like, shit, man, if I was in an office tomorrow, the amount of crop dusting that would be happening, it would be insane.
Do you ever think about like foods that you're about to eat, how many farts that is? I'm like, that's 280 calories probably, but that's really like 6 farts if I'm taking down this slice of pizza. That's just how I see food.
Dude,
Two donut holes, I'm like, that's 4 farts a piece.
Last night, I mean, I'm going on like 36 hours straight of heartburn.
You've been heartburn boy since like low-key high school.
Yeah, I know. It's...
You've been a Tums Titan for a while now.
Yeah, yeah. Now I was a Tums Titan. Now I got Pepsi Pride. I made the switch.
Pepsi player.
I got the banner in my basement, you know, with the marker on it, you know, like the cheerleaders riding.
What do you mean?
Pepsi Pride.
Oh, you break out of that thing every Sunday?
Yeah. Yesterday, definitely. But it was like, damn, I had to keep going back to the well, brother.
Oh, you're just...
I've just been going on. I've just been living with heartburn since like 2 p.m. yesterday.
Damn, I got it one time when I was a kid before a Colts game. I'll never forget it. I took down a Whopper in like 5 seconds at a Burger King. And I was like... I was in my dad's Ford Taurus. I was like, ah! And he was like, what's going on? I was like, I don't know. He's like, you got heartburn, bro.
Yep. It's rough, dude. I do it totally to myself. I mean, you know, Super Bowl Sunday, yeah, right. So we're just having, had tiny meatballs that had jalapenos in them. Tiny jalapeno meatballs, chili bean dip, buffalo chicken dip. My buddy ordered pizza at halftime.
Let's talk about it, yeah, dude. So what pizza, what kind, Donato's. And who the fuck was that bold?
Donato's, and it really, they got there in like 20 minutes. It's very impressive. I was like, I don't know if we just beat, you know, they're all just like giving high fives to each other. Like, we made it through another Super Bowl Sunday. Yeah. We get one order and they're like, ah, fuck. But it won't be bad because it's just like, you know, one, the last ones that are trickling in. So it got there in like 20 minutes, which is pretty cool.
I wonder if that's a top pizza day, Super Bowl day.
Yeah, but then just like, you know, had some beers and shit. You're fucking
beers.
Yeah, dude.
So, I mean, I just absolutely just had the flames going up from my chest through my throat.
Father fart.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, chili bean dip. Come on.
That sounds like a fart. That's all you got to say instead of chili bean dip. What's on the menu? In some chips. Oh, okay. I'll be there.
Hey, everybody's on the CBD kick of, you know, they're taking the CBD, make yourselves feel better. I'm like, nah, I'm not on that CBD. They're like, what are you talking about? I'm like, chili bean dip. That's my CBD.
Oh my God. Do you have any CBD oil? You're like, yeah, take out a crock pot. You're like,
smoking CBD. You're just like,
what's up?
CB infused with CBD. Sounds good to me.
Yep. CBD tacos. Fuck yeah. Bring them over here.
So that's what I've, that's what's been happening, man. That's where we're at. God, I want to go back to just ripping those sports talk promos.
Oh, it's pretty good TikTok.
I kind of, I probably just
raw, unfiltered.
We'll be
sports
back.
Talk.
We'll be back. We'll be back.
Raw, unfiltered sports talk. Look, here's the deal. This is what really goes down in a locker room. He speaks the truth. I know you don't want to hear it, but this is how it is.
Keep going. Keep going.
Hot, 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 hot. Just all the most generic shit ever.
Yeah, I'll be all the sound effects. You be the guy.
That all of our father-in-laws or dads are just like... Damn right.
Yeah, I'm like, they're like, what time does that start?
Let's go, Colts. Let's go, Colts.
They're like, what time does that start?
Hot, hot, hot.
In a world where people are afraid to say what's on their mind.
Let's go. Let's go buckle it up four quarters.
That's why you tune in to The Ticket. Weekdays 12 till 3. That's how it's just gonna be. I give you the truth.
That looks like Jerry Rice out there.
Yeah, that's just, it's just a right there. You play that. You if you just blast it out on the speakers, like,
hey, who's not listening?
Well, if you set up giant speakers in the heart of any city and you just blast that out there, it would be like it would be like a siren that just catches all
like a
32 to 56 year old men. It just it's like a dog whistle, and they all like perk up.
Dog whistle for guys with goatees,
and they just instantly become curious.
All of them. Their wives are like, what just happened? They're like, oh, I heard something.
There's been a calling.
All guys with goatees just perk up like dogs. They all just start fucking walking backwards to the same place.
Everybody.
In their Wrangler jeans and shit. All running into each other.
Oh, did you hear it too? I heard it. Let's go. Let's keep going. I don't know where we're going. Let's keep going.
You guys going to The Ticket? Oh, yeah, man. He speaks the truth.
Hot, hot, hot.
Dude, this is my favorite thing.
He's not like, you know, you turn on those ESPN shows, you know. They've just gone down a way. I can't listen to that, man. This guy just tells it how it is.
It's all scripted over there.
So what'd you end up doing for the Super Bowl?
Dude, I didn't watch one play.
You're an asshole.
I swear to God. I didn't watch one snap.
You're such a fucking asshole.
I had to. I was like, when I like realized it was on, it was probably like the second quarter. And I was like, what if I just didn't watch any of it? And... then I was like, I mean, I'm already like halfway there. So I was like, I'm just not going to watch it just to see if I can do it.
What'd you do? Like, what were you doing?
Low key. I was just like kind of, I was writing for a little bit, and then I just started listening to like Linkin Park for some reason.
And I ordered some food and started like trying to redo my website.
So what, like, was there anything on the TV?
No, actually, I did give in. I tried to watch it, but it was like, you need to update your app because you need to on a different account. And I was like, okay, no. Mm. So it was the best night of my life. Oh, and then I went to the store at like 11:50 and I was super down bad and bought some bananas and peanut butter.
Oh,
back on, baby. I was clean for like 2 years off peanut butter, bro.
Yeah. You gonna be on the, you gonna be touring soon? You gonna be PBA touring?
I'm not, dude. Cause I, dude, you know what? They put me in check. TikTok put me in check.
About what?
I went to sleep and I was like, and the first thing I saw was, bro, you're stepping into your bad habits again on my TikTok. I was like, how do they know?
It was just like somebody doing one of those weird TikTok cringe motivational things.
No, it was like text where you swipe.
Mm.
And I was like, how the fuck?
Isn't peanut butter good for you though?
I mean, like, not the way I eat it, dude. I'll eat like a whole entire jar. And the kind I got was peanut butter pretzels and white chocolate. I was like, yeah, see you tomorrow.
Yeah. You're a freak too. I bet you like dip your fingers straight up in it and like do one of these.
Yeah. Well, like I cut up a banana into like pieces like this big, and the peanut butter I put on the banana was the size of the banana.
Yeah, sure. Right. Yeah.
So it's like, you know, this can't be healthy.
Right.
And yeah. So I was like, wow, I need to get my shit together. Too much PB, I guess. And the whole world knows.
PBA tour, man. Yeah. I think you need to bring it back. It's not bad. You know,
it's not too
bad. That needs to be a thing of merch.
PBA tour. Are we touring tonight? Peanut butter apple tour?
Oh, man. This freaking acid reflux. God.
It's got you again?
It's like a mix of Burpee Boy and heartburn. Just sucks, dude.
Acid reflux.
I'm like, I don't want a
superpower.
I don't want to talk to my doctor about it because he's going to be like, well,
he's going to make you stop eating and shit.
Yeah, he's going to be like, what? So, like, you know, kind of run me through your daily, you know.
What a question that is.
And I'll be like, I mean, I wake up, have like at least three cups of coffee. He'll be like, I'm like, yeah. And then, you know, throughout the day, like, you know, especially during the week and shit, I try to, you know, I'm mostly just like drinking on water. You know, I'll have some grilled chicken, some salad, some fruits, you know, stuff like that. Like for dinner, I'll have some salmon, like some green beans. He'll be like, okay, good, good. And then I'll be like, yeah, but I usually have like 2 glasses of wine. And he'll be like, and I don't want to face that. I don't want to face not being able to have wine and coffee.
God, it's a two, those are like my two most favorite things in the world. The only two things, the reasons you're still alive.
Not my son.
Nope. No fucking chance, dude. You tell me if the coffee and wine wasn't invented, yeah, I would have been dead 7 years ago.
I mean, yeah, it's just, it's like, look, I'm willing to battle through and just be Pepsi player and have Pepsi pride. Because I'm not giving that up, dude. I'm not doing it. Like, if it comes down to it, I'll stop drinking beer. I'll stop having the Coke occasionally. Like, if I have to do those things in order to just have wine when I want and then coffee every morning, I'll do it.
Yeah. How about just wine and coffee just being the two grossest things ever when you're, like, growing up?
Oh, yeah.
Well, the first time you tried coffee, I was like, what are we doing drinking this?
Yeah, I thought it was like a giant scam. That, like, you know how like every TV show people, you know, the pot would be running. They'd be like, crazy. Pouring it up. And then a switch flips, man. Like, yeah. like with so much other stuff in life.
Literally, you're like, I'll take the L on the health. I gotta have coffee.
Seriously.
It's amazing.
It's like, I was...
Fourth one today.
Yeah.
This size.
Yeah. It was nice out yesterday. It was nice out.
Flat lines.
Dude, it was nice out on Sunday, and we were doing a little walk, and I was literally, like, I was walking, we were finishing up the walk, I was getting close to my house, and I was looking at my yard, and literally in my head, I was like, that's not a bad looking yard. Like, I'm excited for this weather to start so I can start, like, mowing the lawn.
Ooh. Really? You got house fever.
I mean, and... Talk about what you didn't want to do when you were a kid and a teenager. Mowing the lawn? What a chore.
I don't, yeah, it was, but like after your third time mowing the lawn, it was like, it's kind of nice. No, it's kind of nice to see those lines.
It is, but look, here's the deal. You get excited because you're like, oh, wow, I'm kind of like growing up. Like my dad's going to let me mow the lawn, you know? And then like when you're doing it, you're like, oh, yeah, the lines, it's nice. It's satisfying. But then like after the second time doing it, whenever it's like, hey, need you to get out there, mow the lawn. You're like, mm-hmm. Oh, God, that takes like 40 minutes. It's hot as shit. Yeah. Probably when we bag the grass. Like, I don't
bag the grass. Shit. Who's bagging grass?
I have shitty headphones that like I can't even listen to music.
Every 2-3 seconds, can't even listen to the fucking song.
The volume will be all literally to the full bar. It'll be all the way up. Nope. Can still not even hear anything. Not I'm like, well, thing. I'm getting deaf and I still can't even hear what I want to listen to. So
remember the first time you mowed the grass, like how your dad acted towards you after that? Dude, my dad ripped my fucking ass.
Really?
Oh, because I was missing spots. Dude, I thought I was fucking Scott's turf builder out there. There's fucking blades of loose grass. He's like, hey, dude, he took me out there. Look at this. What about this? You didn't mow the apron, the grass outside of the sidewalk. I was like, that's called an apron?
I didn't know that.
Bro, he put me through it, dude.
Hey, you think that's like the fucking city's problem?
Kind of a little bit. I was like, the neighborhood deals like with this shit, right? No, I just forgot.
Because it was on
I
the was overwhelmed. Right there.
Yeah, bro, side yard.
Your mailbox is in the apron.
I just kind of like spaced it because I was like, oh, I'm done. There's like a part behind our backyard that was like the ditch. Mm. Didn't cut that. Like, I was just... There's a lot of shit going on, bro.
See, I thought you were about to say it's like, you know, a cool father-son moment. You know, your dad's like proud. It's like, yeah, all right, my boy's like doing some manual labor.
Dude, he made me physical cut it labor. Twice.
And then he's like, all right, you're fucking up too much. You're done.
Twice, bro. Shit looked like Wrigley Field.
Man, you want to talk about something I was always still kind of am just fascinated by. How they'd get it to where there's like the patterns in the grass.
Crazy to me. Dude, I think they cut baseball fields and shit normally, and then they paint like darker grass over the top. I think they got us for a scam on that one.
No, I don't think so.
Really?
Yeah.
Wrigley. I mean, really.
Yeah, it's just the way they mow it.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
They can mow logos in that shit?
Maybe not logos, but like when they have like it almost looks like checkered, right? Mm. And it's like, but it's so nice. I don't think that's painted. I think that's just them riding out there and doing like, you know, because they could set. It's almost like when you're shaving or like you're doing a haircut. You know, you want a 2 or 4 on set, right? Like you can set the. You're right. So like part of it's a little bit lower that makes it to where it reflects differently.
Dropping it down a little
I'll never know. I kind of don't ever want to know because I feel like, yeah, they'll be like, oh, yeah, we did just end up painting it. It's just a pattern. I'm like, ah, fuck that. I wish you just would have told me that it was what it was.
It is like in a dude's DNA to like always just like just looking at grass. I just remember growing up walking around the neighborhood. I'd be like, oh, they got a nice edge on that yard. You know, like, who's really thinking that? Now, like, I get what you're saying. Like, you want to edge that fucking... Those like with your on the side of your cement stairs going up,
dude. I love weed eating. Mm. Not even weed eating. I love using the weed eater to fine tune the sidewalk and like on the fence and everything. So it's not just weeds. It's just like you're hard pressed to get the mower right to that area. So you use that shit and you just nail it down. It looks pristine and nice. Mm. Or you ever use hedge clippers, bro?
Oh, I grew up on those little. I had the little, whoa. No, but
no, not the like not these the big scissors. I'm talking. It's almost scissors. Like a. It's almost like a chainsaw, and it's got the chainsaw.
I always wanted
type
to.
Thing going out, and you fire it up, and you're just like, you're going over bushes and shit. You're hacking down trees.
Man, that sounds amazing. Why does that sound amazing?
Hedge clippers. Here we fucking go. Nicola coming through right there. That one.
Oh, yeah. When I was a kid, I always used to pretend that was a chainsaw and chase like my friends around.
Oh, yeah, dude. You can trick yourself into thinking that it's a chainsaw for a little bit. That's a feeling fun pretty
day.
Cool.
That's a fun day to grab that thing off the wall of your garage.
Cut my knee on one of those.
Yeah.
Bro, I was working my summer job when I was 19. I was doing that shit, and somehow it, like, I was trying to get down, like, low on something, and I kind of, like, lost control accidentally, and that shit just, like, jammed into my knee, because those, blades, you know, going like this. So it just jammed into my
knee.
Was it
a stitches situation?
No, it was pretty bloody, but it wasn't stitches. I was all right.
Your old yard work scar.
Clippers I could never, to the knee.
My parents never trusted me with any of that shit, so I had to use like actual scissors when I was like cutting the grass. Like we had these all like hand to like, we didn't have like an edger. We had like a manual thing that you like squeeze it and like.
How long would that shit take?
Forever. I was on my hands and knees just like literally cutting grass with scissors around our deck.
Yeah, I think that was just a punishment. I think they just wanted you to get the hell out of the house.
Nah, bro. Because I would have like sliced my face open if I would have had a weed eater. And we never had a good weed eater either. We always had one that was like always breaking. The little string would fly off. Like, and then you see the landscapers out there with their like, you can cut a whole yard with theirs.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like,
but dude, wow. Yeah, starting up a weed eater, that shit sucks.
I never did it. I was just like,
trying so hard and then trying so hard not to get pissed while you're doing it. Even though the neighbor like down the streets is like, oh, look at that dumbass. He can't get it.
And it's like near the end of the whole lawn thing. You're just exhausted. So you're just checked out.
Done. You're exhausted, man. Fucking throwing it down.
The amount of times I like primed a lawnmower and shouldn't have, you know, you like press that little red button. They couldn't make that look more inviting. That red button. I'm like, damn, I want to eat that button.
Your thumb goes like fully into it. Yeah. You know,
there's like gas behind it. It's like, you're like, ooh, I could feel
that's
that.
Nice.
I'd prime a lawnmower 376 times. Fire that bitch up. Still wouldn't work.
Yeah, what I was going to say. Yeah.
Like God,
no matter how primed you were, nothing. NFL prime. Sorry about you. Still not working.
NFL prime, lawnmower prime time.
Yeah, so you didn't even see the Rihanna halftime show or nothing?
Nothing, bro. Well, I saw a lot of it on social media. So
and like, to be fair, for everybody who's been listening, you know, I followed through. I did exactly what Ben said. It was literally the kickoff was in the air, opening kickoff. And I texted Ben, said, "You do anything for the Super Bowl?"
Too early, bro.
It's still too early.
Too early, dog.
I said, fuck you. And I went and got more meatballs. Bro, they didn't have a Super Bowl themed cookie cake.
What?
I was pissed. So I just had to get a regular cookie cake and like talk my way and being like, well, it's kind of like balloons. So it's kind of like
it's a party, you know, for like, something.
It's a party. It's kind of like celebrating the team. It's got a red and a yellow one on there. Yeah, man, I got there hurts. Too late, man. It was Sunday morning, and shit was popping. I mean, I literally had to do four laps around the market parking lot. There wasn't a spot, man.
What?
Was not a spot.
Every spot was taken?
I'm not exaggerating.
Pay for parking down the street.
Four laps through to find a spot, finally.
That's tough.
It was very tough.
You kind of just want to go home.
I was thinking about it.
Yeah, like, do we even need to do this anymore?
Exactly. I was like, it's just a cookie cake. And
I'd
like
tap out quick,
a six-pack of Bud Light.
Got it. Those are the two things you need, though.
I know.
Deep down. You're like, damn, if I just wouldn't have been a bitch at the store earlier. Like you know.
I know. I was like, should have pulled the trigger on Wednesday. Should have pulled it on Wednesday.
Nah, nobody's doing that. I'm just thinking, like, when it's near the end of the game and you really need that, like, whatever, seventh Bud Light and that slice of cookie cake and you don't have it, bro. You just looking at yourself in the mirror like, who am I?
I think it's almost like impossible to get drunk on Super Bowl Sunday. Because I was like,
definitely.
Me and my whole, like, the group of people that were over at my house, like, I was consistently having beverages from
6,
probably 4 o'clock.
Ooh.
Until
midnight?
10. And I remember at one point, I think the start of the fourth quarter, where I had my beer in my hand. I like took a drink and I kind of like looked at it and I was like, what is this even? This isn't even doing anything.
Oh, I hate that. That's pissed. A horrible feeling.
Horrible.
You're like, what am I? This is doing nothing to
I'm
me.
Just,
I'm killing myself slowly.
Right. I'm giving myself heartburn. My face is going to be all chubby. I'm about to piss 16 times tonight.
You had a real moment with yourself, bro.
I
that
did.
Hurts.
I think I stopped after that. I think
did you even drink the rest of the beer?
I don't think so. Yeah, I was like, this is pointless. This is literally pointless.
Were you pissed?
Kinda.
About what?
The fact that I was just like, I don't even have like a buzz, not even Super Bowl buzz.
It's weird how sometimes when you drink, you just don't even, doesn't even happen.
But then sometimes I'll have three beers and I'm like,
oh my God, we should move to California, saying some dumb shit.
Exactly. Why does that happen like that?
What we're going to do is we're going to go in our RV together. Okay?
Yeah. We should get one of those school buses, refurbish it.
We're going to go in an RV together. We're not going to, we're going to tailgate every single Colts game in the RV. Mm-hmm. We'll just split it, man. After three Bells Two Hearted.
Bro, I already bought a school bus. Look. I already bought the paint, dog. Look. Yeah. One sip.
Dude, that Super Bowl Sunday, 6 hours of steady drinking. I'm literally couldn't be more mad.
Mad and sober. Bloated as fuck.
Dude, just feeling like absolute shit.
Just ate 94 peanuts.
17 meatballs.
Somebody's mad at you.
Yeah, bro. Everybody's talking about Jalen Hurts' stat line from Sunday night. What was it? What was your stat line from, well, you were doing stupid shit. I was about to say
stat line, like
Jalen Hurts went fucking 24-31, 341 yards, four touchdowns. I'm like, tight. I had six Bud Lights, four pieces of pizza, 18 meatballs, 12 pigs in a blanket, and two rounds of chili bean CBD.
Yeah. You're the side chick for sure, going in on those sides.
Mm-hmm.
I was Caesar salad, double chicken, and 10 wings from the tap. I had two Propels, two glasses of wine, two bananas, and a full jar of peanut butter.
That's an interesting one. You know what you are? You're like Debo Samuel. You're taking handoffs.
He can do it all.
Right. You're taking handoffs. You're getting screen passes. You're going deep.
Yeah. I'm returning
just,
kicks.
Yeah. I'm just straight up like if Derrick Henry was in the Super Bowl.
Running downhill.
Downhill, man. You don't want Molinaro to start getting a full head of steam.
As the game goes on, he gets stronger. Yeah, he gets stronger. Dude, every fucking announcer ever pulled that one out of the bag. I think even I did when I was calling games.
Oh, later in the game, this guy gets better and better. It's like he doesn't get fatigued. He gets more energy. All right, here we go. 2nd and 10.
Dude, can we call a game?
Please.
Oh, my God. Wait. I would be play-by-play, yeah, and you'd be color. You'd be fire at color.
Really?
Yeah.
I think the opposite. Like, I think it'd be fine either way, but I think you're just more of like, you'd have the quirky, funny, dumbass comments.
Nah, man.
I would just paint the picture.
Hey, we could switch it up. We can switch off. Second half.
You're right, though. I would be able to just like fake it with like bullshit like that to like sound, I would just basically say everything like Greg Olson would say.
Perfect.
You know? So no Rihanna halftime show, huh? You see she's pregnant?
Yeah.
That's pretty wild.
That's all I saw. Yeah.
Everybody, like the whole time, everybody everywhere, it was just like that kind of quiet, unspoken, like.
Is she?
I don't want to be the first one to say it, but I think she is.
Yeah, why does it feel like you'd be in trouble if you said that? Like, if I was like, is she pregnant? It's like, oh, you're rude.
Right. Just wait for a woman to say it.
Just text any girl you know. Like, hey, can you say this real quick so we can all talk about it? Because I'm going to get in trouble. I'm going to get banned from my own house if I say this. Normal question.
Just, Nicole, stop.
What'd you talk about?
R-H-I-A-N-N-A?
Bro, I still don't know how to spell Rihanna or Wiz Khalifa. Every time I type it in, I'm like, dog, just help me out. just Google, help me out. Rihanna's a tough one, bro.
It's really not.
Words that you still can't spell. Rihanna, Wiz Khalifa for me. And similar. Every time I spell similar, I'm like, what am I doing?
So, hey, how about similarly?
Oh, yeah, get out of town, bro.
The whole family of similars.
It's tough.
Similarities. We going Y or IES here?
I don't know, man.
That's what I'm saying.
A lot of, dude, that I get stuck on a lot of IES or Y. If you think about how hard spelling is sometimes, it's amazing.
Accommodate. Yeah, a lot of 1C, 2Ms. What are we doing?
On the mainstream, I don't know how to spell this. I got you definitely. We all know. Restaurant. But the first time
conscientious. Wow.
I haven't even said that in like 7 years. Entrepreneur. Dude, exercise gets me every time.
Really?
I don't know how to spell exercise.
What do you?
I don't know. I'm like, where's the S and the C? What are we doing? Sometimes I'm like, there's not a Z, is there?
Size. Exercise.
How about when people spell defense with a C sometimes? You just want to slap the shit out of them.
You're like, why are you from Canada?
I'm like, yeah. I love how you can tell foreign people. They just drop a U in like flavor. You're like, okay, bro.
What? Yeah, what is the deal with that?
It's so funny. They'll tag an E at the end of shop. I'm like, okay. Sign a declaration or something while you're at it, dog.
Until with two L's? Come on. That's down on the list.
Somebody in your comments dropping a U in a word that doesn't have a U. You're like, all right.
Oh, okay.
I got some reach.
Getting some UK viewers. Oh, maneuver? That's not how you spell maneuver.
I don't think it is either.
There's no O in there.
We'll see.
Bro, why did growing up definitely, why was definitely one that was like that too?
Still kind of trips me
up. Why did I always want to spell it defiantly? Definitely left an AIM away message when I was in like sixth grade that was like, the Steelers are defiantly going to win this weekend.
Wow, he's serious about that.
Yeah, I was going to say no O on that shit with maneuver. M-A-N-E-U-V-E-R. Right. Spelling bee. Maneuver. Did you ever do spelling bee?
We can do that right now.
Did you ever do it? Like when you were in grade school?
Nah. I don't think so. No. I didn't. We never had the... Was that a thing?
Yeah, it's true. Where we were, it was never like we never did the thing where everybody got up on stage and then went up to the mic, and we never did that. We had spelling tests, but we never had that like public embarrassment of, you know.
I should have been stoned. People should have thrown rocks at me for the way I used to go up to the board when there was like a math problem and just butcher that shit. One time I wrote a 3 backwards, bro. I was like, I'm gonna just be too sick tomorrow. Yeah, dude, I was just, you know, I was ready. Then I was like, is it that way,
bro? When you when you'd be doing like teachers would have the games where you'd be like doing prep for a test. Oh, and yeah, you would have 2 different teams, and it was like board races is what it was. Oh,
dude, my worst nightmare.
Oh, it's terrible, man.
Public humiliation.
Absolutely. And like you would just be out there absolutely just
On an island,
drowning. And then somebody, like the person that you're going against, would start writing something, and you would try to be like pull it off. Like it happened at the same time for you, but you're just seeing what they're writing.
Yeah, you're like.
And then they like turn their body towards it because, of course, it's like the smart girl. So she knows like this dumbass isn't going to do anything. Yeah, you're like, I would always I would pull the Billy Madison joke out of my ass and just put like Rizzuto, and then everybody, you know, my teacher would be pissed. I'd be like, well, whatever. Oh,
did you really pull that?
Yeah, because I'm like, I mean, I'm not going to not put anything, and then, you know, that'll get a few people to at least be like, Billy Madison!
This is pretty slick, funny move, dude. Yeah, somebody, I don't think I was pulling that at all.
Somebody would give me like, those are Z's. I'd be like, all right, cool. We're down to clown here.
Oh, yeah.
The kid that like you never really hung out with, but maybe you'd be like, maybe we could be friends.
Yeah, he watches movies with his dad. On like weird weekends when he's over there. You know?
We're in sixth grade. He's already definitely seen Caddyshack like 18 times. Yeah,
like that kid has an Xbox. He definitely watches porn like weirdly. Like we're on the same page. Like your friend that you're like you would be best friends with, but he's like kind of embarrassing to be around. But like image, he gets all your jokes and shit.
The image you can't live with it.
I can't be friends with you like that.
That's so shitty, man. That sucks.
Yeah, because I know you got a bad family. Yeah, I can't come over for sure because like your dad smokes and shit. Like obviously.
Dad smokes inside. You drink so much Mountain Dew.
Yeah.
And all you want to do is watch Animal House. Mm-hmm. And we're 11.
You don't play sports either and shit. And you collect Pokemon cards, and my dad doesn't know what those are, so I can't come over tonight. But low key, like, we're homies. After all that.
Like, I want to sit next to you in class. Like, that would be, you know, that'd be cool. But that's like the extent of what we could do.
Yeah, that's our relationship. And he knows.
Yeah, that is nice when, like, but then sometimes, dude, I would get hit with, like, the kid that was like that who would literally call me out on it.
Oh, damn. Like, why don't you want to be friends with me?
Well, he kind of, like, tossed out, be like, yeah, why don't you come over? Oh, wait, I forgot. You can't come to my house.
He would do that?
Joey can't come to my house.
What a bad motherfucker kid was.
And I'd be like, dude, shut up.
Yeah, like, it's not my call. It's my parents. Throw the old parents card on there. They won't let me stay the night yet.
It's my parents, but deep down you're like, I am kind of scared to go to your house.
Yeah, like, are you going to stab me if I don't come over? Like, he kind of has a pocket knife on him a little bit. Like, you saw it fall out of, like, the front pocket of his backpack, and you're like, oh, shit. He's real. He's definitely had a beer before.
Just not afraid at all to get detention.
Mm-mm. Always wearing a little too much black on dress down day. I'm like, you listen to a lot of bands. Can't be friends with you. Oh, shit. He has a Blink 182 folder. My mom's not going to like him.
Dude.
He kind of had the hairs parted in the middle.
Oh, yeah, kinda, man. That sucks, dude. I do not, like, I don't want to be that way for my son, but then what if my son is that kid and then people are, like, saying, like, oh, I can't come over to your house because you know, I just don't want to do that.
It's rough. It's a rough life.
It is, man. It's scary.
Parents know, though, man. Like, my mom would only let me hang out with kids that, like, when she was friends with the kids' moms. Like, you can't go over to his house. I don't know his mom. It's like, it's because we weren't on the same basketball team. I can't, like, be friends with
him. Hey, get to know.
I don't know his mom. I'm like,
get to know the mom. Because
you've never been to anything that I've done ever at school. You don't even know a day we have school.
Get to know the mom.
Yeah, when moms would be too close of friends, though.
Oh, God.
All right. You guys aren't in school anymore. Your day's done.
They love it way too much.
Hey, let's just, you know, go to work or take us to, you know, it's your day for carpool for practice. All right. That's it. That's all it is.
I hated that carpool, bro.
Dude, carpool. Okay. You could at least work out a deal with, like, your boys kind of to carpool with sports.
What year are you talking about? Like, how old are you? Like, high school type shit?
Well, like, grade school, middle school. Early high school when you couldn't drive.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Carpools on the way to school, always the most fucked up people. Why is it always just like people that you... that is the only connection is that somehow they live like four streets over. And so they're like, yeah, I talked to him at parents' night out and we're going to be carpooling together. You're like, what?
This fuck? This kid? He's so pale I can see his veins. Like, I don't even...
I'm going to get in their van? You're going to let me do that?
They're going to talk to me? I don't know these fucking people. I'm going to smell like their van for the rest of the day? Like, this is crazy. Carpooling is... Toss me into the most awkward situation you can.
100%.
When I'm 12.
That's every carpool to school. And, of course, it's early in the morning. Nobody wants to be there already. Dark outside. The dad's listening to really weird music or Bob and Tom.
Or nothing. Nothing's wild. We always had nothing on. I was like, oh, this is horrible.
Your dad wouldn't listen to anything?
I can't. Nah, man. Because it's just too weird.
What do you mean? It's more weird not to listen to something.
Well, he would listen to like Bob and Tom.
Yep.
And then like when there's a bunch of kids in the car that are 10... I love you, burpee boy. Whoa, you can't listen to Bob and Tom. But damn, that shit sounded good on the way to school. Their laughs and stuff. I was like, I want to listen to that. I don't even know what they're talking about.
No, so, so crispy.
Yeah, it was.
In rhythm together.
Oh, yeah. And every time he like switched over to Bob and Tom accidentally, they would be dying laughing. And it would actually be funny to me, too. And I was like, I don't even know why.
Listen to that. But he's like, hey, you know, kind of nod in the back because of the weird carpool family that you're with.
Yeah.
Can't put that on. I'm not in charge of what they listen to.
They'd say like penis or something.
Right. And then they go home and tell their parents, and now it's weird for your parents and their parents.
Yeah, what are we going to do on Halloween when we got to step up to the plate at their house? That public shame. But yeah, so my dad wouldn't like play the popular radio station either, because he wasn't on 93.1 Vibes.
No.
He was on like some weird like X103 Rob Zombie shit. So
nothing.
I don't know, bro. He was probably relying on me to like talk to him or something. I wasn't saying a damn word. On the 6:50 a.m.?
Did you ever start wearing headphones yourself?
Oh, my dad offered to buy me headphones so we didn't have to listen to Chingy in the car. Not during carpools. But he was like, can you play this circus music in your own headphones? I was like, Dad, this is that shit, actually.
Such football coach.
I like it when you do that right there.
Turn that crap off.
Holiday Inn. I was like, this is the best song I've ever heard in my life. Don't you got your own little AirBuds or pods or whatever the heck they got going on here?
Get yourself a headset and turn that crap off.
Headsets.
Every dad and coach somehow, like, their accent just totally, it's one accent. It's not like a regional accent. It's just the dad coach accent when they start getting into that mode. Turn that crap off. Like, is that Pittsburgh? Is that what is that? Buffalo?
No, yeah, it's just one.
Coach Dad.
Yeah, it's Coach Dad. They just hit a different level of like, hey, Coach Dad. Every dad's got a little coach in him.
That was just a clearing the throat.
I
don't want you to jump in on it too much.
No, I was good on that. I was good on that.
What else? Yeah, the show on Fox after the Super Bowl.
What do you mean?
Did you see what it was? Last week we were talking about the come down of like what the hell?
Yeah.
It was the worst, like Fox didn't even try. It was just some weird Gordon Ramsay cooking show that was like a competition. Oh,
that's what you texted me. I was like, what is he talking about?
I couldn't believe it. I was like, it's not even like a scripted drama that maybe would hold people. Nah, first thing, just Gordon Ramsay just being like, I have a few of the worst bakers in the world in my kitchen, and this is how we're following up the Super Bowl. And then it's like, it went into it. I was like, it's already over?
That might get some of the moms, though. I think they were trying to hold the moms over on one.
Moms aren't.
Pull the wool over the moms. Cooking?
Moms aren't. No, they weren't. They're not in it at that point in the game.
They're gone.
The Super Bowl.
My mom would watch the Super Bowl in the other room.
Yeah. I mean, by that point, it's totally background noise or it's already off.
Gotta get kids to bed. Bro, one time my dad just right when the Super Bowl ended, I think I said some dumb shit during the Super Bowl and got in trouble. You ever been in trouble during a Super Bowl? Oh, shit. I said something stupid. And right when the game ended,
TV off.
TV off. Let's take Aaron home. I was like, did something so stupid. I didn't even go home with him. You know, you like your dad's dropping you and your homie off and you ride with him.
Yeah.
I couldn't even go on the trip to his house. My dad just dropped Aaron off in complete silence, came back to the crib, dude.
Oh, you had to stay home?
Dude, he's like, nope.
Your poor friend. Dude, yeah. And that whole time that he's gone, you just know they're just an absolute just whooping verbally, maybe physically is waiting for you.
Like I'd try to go to sleep, a fake sleep, dude. Ooh. You ever pull the fake sleep because you don't want to get yelled at?
You pull the fake sleep, but then sometimes they're so mad. Lights come on.
Oh, shit.
Don't care. They know you're fake sleeping, but even if they aren't, they don't care.
Yeah, give me the heat now because I don't want it in the morning on the way to school either, that Monday morning after
or
the
like
Super
when
Bowl.
They try to like hold out for, you know what I mean? You're like, when is this coming?
I hate that.
Like the ride to school, it's weird, but there still isn't like one of those. And then the whole day at school and then football practice, you're like, what? I mean, geez.
Dude, being in trouble while football practice is happening is
can't like, focus on anything.
I'm like, I got shit going on, coach. I don't know, bro. I can't do leg raises.
Blitzy! What's going on up there? Talking about in your head. You're like, honestly, do you want to know?
Honestly, I think my mom knows I watch porn. I don't know.
I don't know. I forgot to clear the search history, coach.
Like, I tried to clear it, and it won't clear. My mom might have, like, looked at that shit during practice. You understand the heat I'm under right now?
Yeah,
no shit about St. Pius, dog. I got bigger problems.
I think it,
I went to Playboy.com, and that shit might be on there.
Dude, I think if an eighth grader said that to me, I'd kind of be like, all right, and I'd pull him off to the side. I'd be like, Coach, give us five. Or, you know, hey, Thomas, get in. And I'd take that kid to the side.
Oh,
like,
the baller move. Captain, dude.
I'd be like, hey, all right, now, I understand. Okay, we've all been there. All right, it's going to be all right. But I need you to lock in. I'd be like, listen, here's what's going to happen. They're going to approach you about it. All right?
Stuff.
Honesty is the best policy. All right, son? Be honest about it. Okay? They'll forgive you. Be a learning experience, but now get your fucking head in the game because we got to run this pitch, this power toss.
All right. Yeah.
You know, you give him a little 3-minute reset.
You got me, bro. I'm ready now. I'm good.
Give him a little 3-minute reset. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then now this kid's like, wow, coach is like on my side. This is dope.
Yeah. Like he might have my back. If, right. Like, my parents like hold me out of the game because I'm in too much trouble.
See, but then honestly, you do that though. And then your coach's like, what world do you think this is? I don't give a shit about what's going on at home, son. It just makes it even worse.
It
even worse. And then you're doing up downs. Your coach is pissed at you. Your mom's watching fucking porn that you looked up.
Dude. Oh my God. Like, you ever think, how about, did you ever get in so much trouble that the school would call your house?
Oh, yeah.
And your mom, oh my God. And then your mom picks you up and you're like, what I meant? Did they actually talk?
Or what about when it's like after school and you're there and you're like, yeah, I mean, like I kind of mouthed off to my teacher, like I did some dumb shit, but like, I think it'll be all right.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden, like, the caller ID is like, call from Barnabas Saint Catholic Church. And you're like, oh man, Mrs. Kitchens is calling my house right now.
I would literally fucking mom picks up the phone.
Hello, this is Lori. Oh. This is she. And like, and then she looks at you.
Kind of
like,
a bitch.
Done.
Kind of like a what he do tone.
Oh man.
Super fake.
And then it would be like she would just give you a little for me, she would just give me a little like. And then you're like, what? What, mom? Even though you know. And then it's like dad, and then it's like dad wasn't home from work yet, so it's like she had to wait until dad was back, and then they were gonna full court press you. And then dad's pissed because he's had a full day of work. You know, boss is riding his ass or whatever. Didn't close the deal. He's got to come home and deal with the boy who mouthed off to his teacher.
What'd you say?
Man, I learned from the best. Like, honesty is the best policy, for real.
You just fessed up. Bro, I lie my ass off.
Because every time that I did that, my parents would just be like, no, that's not how it happened. Like, what really happened? No, but she said, but the teacher hates me. No, they don't. What'd you do? And it's like, all right, fine. I threw erasers at her head.
Ooh. At the teacher, for real? Or are you just kidding?
No, I was like kind of, I don't know. I was like, I remember this one time.
Was it a Friday?
It wasn't like at her head. Like, it was one of those, like, we had kind of verbally like gotten into it a little bit. I was being a smart ass. And then we had like our dry erase boards or whatever. And like, she said something that was like,
the teacher?
Yeah. She said something that was pretty like, you know, everybody's kind of like, ooh, and I kind of just like flinged my eraser and it like went up and hit the chalkboard. Yeah. It wasn't like,
oh, that's crazy.
I wasn't like throwing it at her. It was just like,
it was a reaction.
And you're like, that, you know?
Oh, that's wild, dude.
Yeah.
That's wild.
One of those situations. Yeah. But
got the call. Yeah. Got the call. The call home.
Got
bro.
The call from the big leagues. You're being sent down, son.
Rough life.
Mm-hmm. All right. These guys 21.
Wait.
Okay.
Before we wrap it up.
Mm-hmm.
If we get a minute. Come on. The people want it. You know it.
I don't really... Dude, I...
Oh, don't pull this stunt.
Stunt?
Don't pull this.
What are you talking about?
Don't pull the wool over us for this. I know you're mad at something.
Why are you saying... Why are you putting that on me?
The minute, bro.
I know, but like, why are you like, I know you're mad at something.
Something's
like,
going on. I'm
pissed off all day.
There's got to be something. You're like, fuck, you know?
I mean, I guess just like in a situation like last night, like I'm just so tired of every single game that isn't just a regular season game. And most of the time, even in regular season games, like if your team doesn't win, grown ass men just being like, just against the refs, tough when it's, you know, Pat Mahomes against the, you know, with the refs, tough when you're playing the refs.
Got the rest in your pocket.
Got the rest in your pocket.
It's like that.
All right, the rest. You came down to the refs. Dude, shut the fuck up. Like, the Eagles had a 10-point lead at half, right? Like, they had every opportunity in the world. Mahomes was hobbled. Like, the Chiefs couldn't get anything to go. They're barely on the field in the first half. One call.
Such an easy out.
Refs! And I know that, like, it's just like in general. Like everybody, that's all, every single big game on Twitter. Rigged, script, rigged, refs, refs, bro, refs, bro. I'm like, if you're 12 years old, you could be like, refs, bro, take that L. It was the refs, bro. Hey, you're 32.
Zebras, dog, they got us again.
Also, hold that L. Tired of that shit. Hold that L, man. How's that L? Hold that L. Massive L. You should only be, literally, you have to be a little fucking white kid doing a gritty contest at a party or a dance.
To say that.
To say, hold that L. If you're above 12 years old and you say that.
L. L take.
You're a fucking loser. That's what you are. You're big. That's your big L. You're big, hey. L word.
Hey, guys, that say, hold that L. Hold this L.
Exactly. Hold that L up on your forehead and shut the fuck up. About the refs, about holding L's, about, oh, he big mad.
Big mad. Nothing will piss you off more.
And it's all like, I love, like, somebody will say something to you, or just in general. It's not even to me. Like, I'll just see it happening on the timeline. Some fucking, you know, dude will say something to like Mark Schlereth, and then somebody like Schlereth will literally just have like a common response that's just like, you know, pretty good rat-a-tat, like verbatim, yeah, back to him. And then all of a sudden they just like blow up his feed, just being like all the crying laughing emojis. Oh, I got him. Oh, he big mad. Oh,
clown.
Yeah, I'm like, dude, you are being the clown right now.
Yeah.
And also, how are you going to expect for you to say some dumb shit to somebody and then they just respond back to it? And then it's like, whoa, watch out. Hold that L. He big mad. Fucking losers, man. Go crawl into a hole. Shut the fuck up.
All right. Man cave.
TG21.
TG21. Follow us. Subscribe. Watch it on YouTube.
Please.
See you next time.
Bye-bye.
That was a fire minute, bro.